You can't put a price on freedom. See, here's the one thing I finally realized after years of being in business. If you can't do what you want when you want, you're not free. If you're stuck working in a particular location, you're not free. If you're stuck in a particular city, you're not free. If you can't get up and go whenever you want, you're not free. And that that usually means you don't have residual income coming into your household. And to me, the holy grail of income is residual income. And now, usually it's reserved for the people that are very wealthy. Mm-hmm. It usually is. Because they can invest in those things that can bring it in. That's why I'm so passionate about our business, because we can take the biggest companies in the world, have them play with them and compete with them at the same time, and make as much money as they want.
I love it. Guys, I always like to leave these pod sessions with one tip for the listeners. It could be anything from a leadership perspective, entrepreneurship perspective, real estate, what to eat, what you had for, like, whatever you like. It's your mic.
Go ahead.
I'm going to start with obviously the most beautiful person on this pod session by far.
Oh my gosh, thank you.
I'm going to start with you, Wendy. Whatever you'd like to go with it. Sorry to put you on the spot.
Yeah, that's okay. No, I you know, I'm so grateful to have gotten to where I am today, and it's really not because I'm special. It's just because I just learned a few things. I started listening to people that had what I wanted, and, you know, in every regard, and started following that. So one thing I would tell people is you can't compare yourself to others, because when you do, you know, I feel like what I heard a saying, comparison is the thief of joy. Because, and now in the Instagram and social media age, we're comparing ourselves to everyone else. And so, like, in our business, you know, I didn't break any records like what Franco did in a short amount of time. It took me a long time to do. And I actually learned this from him. And he said, well, you know, keep in mind who you were when you started. So whatever it is you're doing, you know, don't compare yourself to others, because in our business, you know, he came into ACN, had already owned businesses, had already had a ton of personal growth and development. He just had to learn the network marketing, you know, model, our model. And so for me, when I came into our business, I never owned a business. I didn't know personal development was a thing, right?
You're so green to it all, right?
Yeah, I had never done network marketing. And so rather, you know, comparing myself like to someone like him just messes you up. Up in your head, because everyone's always looking at, I'm not good enough. I can't do it. Not for me. And so I think in anything you're doing, whether it's your health or relationships, your business, you can't compare yourself. You know, if you watch racehorses, they have blinders on. Why? Why do they have blinders on? Because if they look to the right and they look to the left, they're going to get tripped up and someone's probably going to die. So they have blinders on so they can focus on moving forward and not seeing what everyone else is doing. And so that would be my biggest thing for people is, if someone else has done it, you can do it. Don't compare yourself. You're not them. Everybody has a different start. Everybody's at a different place. But just don't give up.
Don't give up.
You know, keep going.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Franco LoFranco.
So one thing is to, first I want to acknowledge you, because doing things like this makes a big difference for people. We need more guys doing what you're doing. So I know you love to help people, like to make a difference for people. So we're grateful for people like you, because just listening to this, I know, can inspire people and change somebody else's life, even in a small way, every day. Listen to a positive message, a message of growth and development. And if I could tell people just one thing, every day, just work on yourself. Like, to her point, it doesn't matter what somebody else is doing. What are you doing? What are you doing every day to improve your life? And so one of our owners always says, next year at this time, be here and be a better person.
Be a better person
than you were the year before.
Yeah.
And if you just focus on that, there's no telling what you can achieve and where you can go, because anything's possible. And tip, be healthy. You know, one of the things we focus on a lot is our health. Like, one thing we love doing is intermittent fasting. We love that. Stem cell, we've done a...
Listeners, know, again, these two are like, they look super, super healthy. Glowing, both of you.
Thanks to her.
Yeah.
Right? So, like, stay healthy, because you're important. You matter. Your longevity matters, and the healthier you are, the more of a difference you can make other people. Be an inspiration for people. It's not just always about you. What difference can you make, and what example can you be for others?
Love it. I'm going to close it off by, my tip is Google residual income. Start there if you don't know what it is. And if you do know, get it. Some way, somehow in your life, because it might not be wanting a plane. It might not be wanting extra. time, even mm-hmm. it might just be an extra $1,000 a month that you need to help you pay the bills.
Peace of mind is also priceless.
Priceless. You can't even put peace a tag of mind. On that, right? Yeah. It might be wanting to send the kids to swimming class because you, whatever it is, you need to get some. And I think it becomes, and I can speak for myself when I say it becomes a little bit of a drug. You get some of it and then you want a little bit more of it. You
can't go back.
You can't.
Once you have residual, you can't go back.
They always say if you knew what residual income was, you would go through a brick wall to have it.
They should have taught this in, you know, grade six, seven.
I would have signed up for that class. Imagine us
coming out and understanding it from that age. Franco, Wendy, thank you so much.
Thank you. I cannot
tell you. You're on the other side. We're going to come in for a hug because I'm a big hugger. I really appreciate this, guys. Thank you.
Thank you. It's been fun. Thank you.